what is Ibrahim alayhi salam going to give to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam in those moments as he's meeting the answer, the greatest answer to his greatest dua, the person of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam? Is it merely going to be a meeting of joy, or is Ibrahim alayhi salam going to give an advice that would be of benefit? Subhanallah, it is so beautiful that Ibrahim alayhi salam, who cared so much about the succession of faith in this world, even as he is in the seventh heaven, is still thinking about the continuation of Allah's worship and glory in this world. Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he narrates that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, when I met Ibrahim alayhi salam on the night of al-Isra wal-Mi'raj, he said to me, O Muhammad, send my salam to your ummah. Subhanallah, he sent salam to each and every single one of us. He said assalamu alaykum to each and every single one of us. And we send our salam back to our father Ibrahim alayhi salam. But not only did he send salam to us, he also said, and give them this advice. Tell them that Jannah, paradise, has a vast plain of pure soil and sweet water, and it is set as a plain leveled land. So he's telling us about the soil of Al-Jannah, the soil of paradise. And he said, the plants and the trees on that land, on that plain, grow with the utterance of Subhanallah, walhamdulillah, wa la ilaha illallah, wallahu akbar. Tell them that the seeds that grow, plants and trees in that sweet soil of Jannah that is nourished by the sweet water of Jannah are the sweet words of Subhanallah, walhamdulillah, wa la ilaha illallah, wallahu akbar. Subhanallah, how perfect is Allah. La ilaha illallah, there is no God but Him. Alhamdulillah, all praises are due to Him. Allahu Akbar, Allah is the greatest. Subhanallah, you keep on repeating. Subhanallah, walhamdulillah, wa la ilaha illallah, wallahu akbar. This is a message from the seventh heaven, from Ibrahim alayhi salam to his descendants, because we are amongst those who followed him. We pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala counts us amongst them by virtue of being from the followers of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And this nasiha, this advice is for us, subhanallah, alhamdulillah, la ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar. And so you see something beautiful happening on the night of Isra wal-Mi'raj. When the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam met Musa alayhi salam, Moses, peace be upon him, gave the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam advice that would reduce the prayer for us by the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asking Allah to reduce the requirement of prayer for us so that the burden could be lessened. Ibrahim alayhi salam gave the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam advice to convey to us that would allow us to elevate ourselves so that our rank in paradise would be higher. So what blessed nasiha, what blessed advice we see from these prophets to our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Ibrahim alayhi salam also used to pray for us. How did he used to pray for us? When he used to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Rabbi ighfirli wa li walidayhi. He would pray for himself, he'd pray for his parents, and of course would pray for his father until Allah forbade him from doing so. Wa lil mu'mineen. And he prayed for the believing men and the mu'minat, the believing women, on the day that we would all be resurrected. He prayed for our forgiveness. And this is a lesson for us. How often do we pray for the ummah that we can't see, the ummah that came before us, what is left of this ummah to come after us? How often do we pray for the believing men and the believing women? You have to look at your share of dua that's for other than yourself. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said to us, in a hadith, a narration by Ubadah ibn Samit radiallahu ta'ala anhu, that whoever seeks forgiveness for the believing men and the believing women, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala writes down for him a good deed for every single one of those believing men and believing women. How many believers are in the world today? How many believers have passed? How many believers are yet to come? And you say, Rabbana ighfir lana wa li ikhwanina alladhina sabaquna bil iman. O Allah, forgive us and our brethren who have come before us in faith, those who preceded us in faith, and do not let there, وَلَا تَجْعَلْ فِي قُلُوبِنَا غِلًّا لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. Don't let there ever be a hardship or some hard feelings in our heart towards our brothers, towards our brothers and sisters in faith, رَبَّنَا إِنَّكَ رَؤُوفٌ رَحِيمٌ. And verily, our Lord, you are most kind and most merciful. We say in our du'as, in our khutbas, اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness for the believing men and the believing women, the Muslim men, the Muslim women, those that are alive and those that are dead. And this is a beautiful way of connecting ourselves both to those that have come before us as well as those that would come after us, and of course those that are alive around us today and those that we cannot even meet, that we will never see, but they live at this time and they are our believing brothers and sisters, and we pray for their forgiveness regularly. Lastly, I want you to think about this. Ibrahim alayhi salam, when he also made dua for salah, رَبَّنَا لِيُقِيمُ الصَّلَاةِ, that, oh Allah, that they would establish the prayer. And how powerful is it that our salah cannot be established except with the mention of Ibrahim alayhi salam. We cannot have an established prayer without saying Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ala ali Muhammad kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim.